Hello.
Want to play a game? Let's take a shot for every time I choose not to milk the minor buzz I've gotten from my Carnage voice videos and just talk as me. Should be a ton of fun. I can promise you by the end though, you'll have a little red facial flush action going, so let's get lit, bro. But not to the point where we can't operate a motor vehicle. Now where do we start with this spoiler talk? How about the end? The mid-credits scene that was leaked and shown to me prior to seeing the movie, because YouTube is stupid. But that doesn't take the hype away from the big announcement that Venom is coming to the MCU.
Oh, how exciting for you, Father! The PG symbiote strikes again! What's next? A show on Disney Channel? It should be me going toe-to-toe with the spider, not this pathetic excuse for a symbiote!
But Carnage does have a point here. While I understand the hype surrounding the possibilities of Venom meeting Tom Holland's Spider-Man, I don't much care. And I don't understand the hype. As Venom is the furthest thing from a villain, what's there to be so hyped about? Are you expecting this to redeem the Venom and Spider-Man clash from Spider-Man 3? Me, I'm expecting them to fight for like 30 seconds, make up, and then share a slice of pizza. And that's even if Venom is indeed showing up in Spider-Man No Way Home. I mean, he has to, right? Isn't this the only opportunity? It definitely adds to the whole this is the endgame of Spider-Man gimmick with No Way Home, but it's more of a, you know, this should be cool rather than a this is so hype thing for me. There's not much more spoilery things to dive into, and I already kicked things off beautifully with the big one that I'm neither mad or super hyped about, so therefore I don't have too much of an opinion on it. And this video's gonna suck. But I'm gonna try, goddammit. I can maybe rant on the fact that, as I predicted, Venom needed help to beat Carnage in the end.
Because he's the inferior symbiote!
Like it really takes the douchebag new boyfriend turned fiancé of Eddie's ex for Venom to get his shots in on Carnage. Granted, the scene was funny.
It was not funny!
But why does every damn villain in every single superhero movie need to seem like they're impossible to beat one-on-one to the point that a side character, especially freaking side characters that don't even have superpowers, need to intervene? And why does Venom have to be such a weakling loser, though? I get that they established this in the first movie, I just don't like it. He's gotta stop Eddie's attempts to tame him. And that actually reminds me, he actually does in this movie when him and Eddie break up midway through the movie. And the whole time prior to them being split, he's all like, we should be out there snacking on bad guys. You're holding me, you're holding me back. And then he splits from Eddie, and then doesn't snack on anyone. The one chance that this movie had to let Venom actually be an anti-hero, and they did nothing with it. Sure, the party scene is funny, but I'm sure Venom having a party in his belly and eating everyone there would have been funnier.
But Venom won't do that because he has no symbiote socks hanging between his legs.
Moving on, that dude who almost dies at the end at the hands of Shriek is supposed to become Toxin, and I have no knowledge of the character from the comics, but he looks cool, so right on. Shriek's trying to kill him because when she was younger, he nearly killed her by shooting her in the eye, and that's why her eye is the way it is, and there's this scene where she goes, an eye for an eye, and tries to gouge out his eye, and I didn't really care for Shriek as a character.
Neither did I. Screw that bitch, and her horrible, unbearable voice.
She's Woody Harrelson's love interest, and that's it. Her shining moment in the film for me is when she invades Eddie's apartment when he's not home and says, Broccalicious. The line is so bad that it's good. At least for me. I mean, no, it's still just bad, but I'm never gonna forget it because it was so out of left field. I wonder where Shriek got these personality traits from. Being locked up for so many years, what influenced her to say Broccalicious? I'd like a little bit more history on her, why not? She might not be dead underneath that bell that comes crashing down on her. How cool would it be if this film was rated R, and instead of a bell falling down, it's like a spear or a piece of debris or some shit that goes right through her other eye? Wouldn't that have been sweet? Whenever I think to myself, man, if this film was rated R, and if Venom was actually an anti-hero, I start stripping away all the enjoyment I got out of the movie, and I really did enjoy it. All the stuff I'm stating now didn't get in the way of that by any means. But man, when you sit down and think afterwards, what could have been? It can frustrate you a little. One last thing to end off on that also frustrated me a little, and I don't know why I didn't cover it in my initial review because it isn't too spoilery, but whenever Carnage unleashes some carnage and kills people, there's no security footage showing him doing it. And the places where he wreaks the most havoc, unleashes the most carnage, is when he helps Cletus break out of prison and when he rescues Shriek. And then afterwards, Detective Mulligan is questioning Eddie. People keep mentioning a monster. With all these catastrophic events that Cletus is tied to. But what do they mean by monster, Eddie? You know something that we don't. So you mean to tell me that in a prison, Nuff said. And also in an underground prison where they're keeping a chick with frickin' superpowers that there isn't one single security camera? Are you fucking kidding me?
No, but I destroyed every single security camera! In every single room!
It's the biggest plot hole in the movie. And that really annoyed me. And one last thing, because one last thing is the loneliest number of last of last things that I'll ever do. And two can be as bad as one, but have no fear, the spoiler talk is almost done. Trust me, I'm singing that last line more to myself than you. But the last thing, lastly, before this video is in last place of every video I've ever made, let's make it last. Like it's the last video standing. How long can you last before I leave a lasting bad impression on you so this is the last video you'll ever watch of mine? The music from the trailers, the song, the one that I was just singing, wasn't in the movie. I wish it would have been. Don't know where they could have put it, but that would have been cool if they could have inserted it somehow. What else do I talk about? I don't know. Carnage, I'm dying a slow and agonizing death over here, man. So could you either, like, bite my head off or end this off in song?
No problem! One is the loneliest carnage that you'll ever do. Sony 2 could be a lot more fun, so bring me back or I'll kill you. This is far from over!
Wow, that was terrible. But thanks for not choosing to bite my head off, though. I need it for the outro. If you like this, leave a like, comment, and perhaps subscribe.
And we just might make some more.